Hello everybody. Decided on this video that I'd show everyone my Jersey barriers and the mold I use. Same materials I use for the bricks, but I'm going to show you my mold and what I do for these Jersey barriers. And here's my mold. It's nice, big, heavy. This did take a lot of the silicone material, but with the extra heat and everything, I just want to make sure it was going to hold up really well, because these do get quite warm during the cure process. So it's relatively thick. The thinnest part's right in here, but it's still a half inch thick. It did, like I said, I used a lot of material to make this mold, but I'll be able to get a bunch of Jersey barriers out of this. It does take a lot of material too, but the total weight for this guy is just under 3 pounds. So it's 1,273 grams. So it's 2 pounds, almost 13 ounces, 12.9. So 2 pounds, 13 ounces. So we're just under 3 pounds. So, but we're gonna weigh out our material. So when we do, we're gonna weigh out about 1,300 grams, a little over 1,300 grams of material to mix into our container here, mix it all up. And I got my other bricks, they'll take the overflow for what doesn't fit in there, but I want to make sure I have enough material in there. So we'll take our container, we'll zero out, throw our tear on there, dig into my big bucket of rockite. This takes so much material. All right, so there's all that good right there. 1265. That should work. We have 80 grams of tear. So that should be enough material right there. Alright, so now we'll take that material. It feels so much heavier. Pour that in here. All right. Now, let me make sure we're still good. We will take and grab our mix stick. And one thing I want to point out about this mold before we get started is you see it's real floppy, right? So that's all right. You would want something that would firm this up if you wanted to just do a flat jersey. But as you can see on my jersey barrier, I've got the fork slots molded into it. And I've got those pre-made right here. So that actually gives me the gap that I need. So I'll be putting these in. And then we'll put these on. First, I'm gonna give it a quick little spray with some silicone release. just to make sure it comes out of there nice and easy. Okay. And we'll put these guys on and we'll just pour around them. I've already got these set to the preset width I want, so we're not over squeezing. And I pre-sprayed these. We'll get those in place. Okay. Now we'll just pour around that. Okay, now we can mix up our rock kite. And remember, be careful with the water. Add enough to start getting yourself a slurry. And then add just little bits of water at a time. Because once it's wet, it gets watery fast. I already got, I'll need a little bit more water from this, I think. Get that mixed up real good. Dry stuff at the bottom, your corners. Get a little thinner, just a little bit of water. And we want it to just flow nicely. Make sure that there's no air bubbles. And again, if you get it too thin, you'll wind up with a bunch of air bubbles. The rest of the water right there. Pretty decent. All right. Easier for me to pour from this side over here. Try not to get too much in your view here. But we'll just start pouring it in. I got nice heavy third syrup. Too much. Get some in the center. Easy. Don't make too big of a mess here. Looks decent. Get more over here. A bit more over on this side. Okay. And let's see where we're at. Wiggle, jiggle, make sure it gets in the corners. Put that excess in here. Might want to thin that just a touch bit more for these bricks. That was just real nice consistency for my jersey. Mess. That's a lot thicker than what I do for pouring my normal bricks. Here. But it will still work. I just don't like to waste any of this material, so I want to make sure I use it all. Make sure we're nice and level. Beautiful. Now, the nice thing is the same set time whether you're using the bricks, doing the bricks, or we got just a touch bit of water to that. Tiny little bit of water. I like to get that thin enough to get that poured in there really quickly here. And this will be a little bit messier than usual. Bricks. Because I'm just trying not to waste material, and I'm just going to do a fast pour on these. I think I'd probably go down to 1200 grams on my clay material, but this is actually turning out pretty decent. I'm not even going to get all my bricks. Filled up on this. Scrape these sides down. Material's starting to set. And once it starts setting, you don't have much time to work with it. Alright, so now I'll grab my spatula here. Get in here and pull these down, level those bricks off. I don't know, I might be able to pull enough material still out of that bucket. Some of that fell down there. If you scrape these too much, you can pull some material out and you'll get kind of a concave effect in there. We don't want that. See, that's starting to set really good already. Yeah, just nice and flat, even with the top is what we're looking for. And let me grab myself some material out of there. Actually get all of our bricks So that actually turned out to be a pretty decent amount. Get all my little bricks along with my jersey. Because I used all my bricks up building that retaining wall out there. So I don't have any bricks left. So I need some just for static display on the dock. Just because it looks cool. Get in there. Let me grab a little bit more material here. I just want to put a drop or two in this one. Drop in that one. Okay, get this even out. Okay, so 30 minutes, and this should all be set and ready to go. So I'll go set a timer. We'll watch this and fast forward. Just want to clear out the edges. As long as your mold is level, everything should come out just fine on here. Because I gave it a good wiggle to shift everything. Make sure my center, my two sides are the same level. So we'll let that be. And then, well, especially this here. Because I'm trying to reuse these centers as well. So I want to make sure those are clear and I don't break those. Alright. I'll touch it until I do something I don't want to. Alright. I like it. Stop it. Let's get that. Ah, see? It's alright. I'm gonna be touching it. Okay. Be back in 30. So we're at our 30 minutes, and we'll harvest our bricks first real quick, just to check on everything. And with the silicone spray, these do come out a little bit easier. Not much, but a little bit. But I'm hoping it helps extend the life of the molds. Oh, it was a little thick, I think. Look at that. See? That brick didn't turn out too hot. So, be one of my scraps. That's what happens if the material's a little bit too thick. It doesn't flow to the edges. And so that's why I wanted to thin it out. But we got several good ones. So, glad I thinned it out instead of trying to fight with it. The molds off really good. Okay, and before putting them away, I'm just going to give it a quick spray. these. Look pretty decent. Yeah, with the smaller material, the runnier you want your mix. So it will run into all the tiny little crevices. Whereas with these, we don't have tiny little crevices. So we don't have to worry about it being all that thin. With that spray, the molds clean off a little bit easier too. Like I said, it's just a silicone mold release. All right, so set those off the side. We'll pull those guys up. Give it just a quick little release there on the side. And then I just push in at the top. Oh, you should feel how warm that is. And there we go. I'll pull my fork molds out. Yeah, well, new ones every time on that. I was going to try to salvage them, but they just stick in there too well. So, but it's just, I use just some foam. I could use wood or something. I make them reusable, but I got plenty of foam board, so I'll just use foam board. Continue with that, but I got those forks, and there it sits. So, nice and neat. I got all kinds of debris on the floor now. So, but that's how I make my Jersey barriers, and mold is ready to go. And we make several more. So these turned out, I think I figured the cost is just, it's a little over $3 for one of these. I have the RC four-wheel drive ones. These plastic Jersey barriers, which look really cool because they come in red and white. Let's see, I've got the white ones. So they come in red and white, fill them with water. You could fill them with sand, but I like to fill them with water. And these look cool. Let me give you a little size comparison here as to how they fit. And I went with a little bit larger highway style Jersey barrier for my mold as well to when I scaled it out. They do have a smaller, about 32 inch, which would come in just a little bit shorter than this one. It'd be about right here for 1/12 scale. But I like the way the larger ones look out there with my models and with the trucks. Bumpers come up to about here. So they just look a little bit better with the larger size jerseys than the smaller ones. The smaller ones would use less material, which would be nice, because these do take a lot of material. Again, they come out about $3, a little over $3 a piece for the material to make these. And these actually come out to only be about $2 a piece for these RC four-wheel drive. But these ones I'll be able to leave out all year, you know, because they are cement, so the weather's not going to have that much effect on them. There's no place for water to get in and corrode them and stuff, whereas these are going to freeze and probably crack and break if I leave them outside during the winter. I can leave these out year round and no problem. And plus the concrete looks cool. So anyway, so that's that. Put them together and we'll start getting some barriers put up out in our construction zone. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks for joining.